सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष्या शून्यवादी अस्तत्याभिशाचारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण कन्या प्रभो नित्यानंद श्रीहतवासवृंद कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे
Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pustaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Dinamo Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschachate Shatane Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
So there are 14 different levels of planets in the universe.
整个物质宇宙呢有十四个不同的星系.
Bhur, Bhuvah, and Tvah are considered the best planets in the universe. Bhur, Bhuvah, and Tvah.
Bhur, Bhuvah, and Tvah 被认为是整个宇宙最为吉祥的地方.
And from those three, the best is considered Jambudvip.
那么在这三者之中呢，最好的地方叫做Jambudvip.
And in Jambudvip, the best place is called Bharatvarsh.
而在Jambudvip最好的部分呢，叫做Bharatvarsha.
Bharatvarsha, named after a great king called Maharaj Bharat.
Bharatvarsha这个名字来源于一位伟大的国王，他叫Bharat Maharaj.
So this earth planet was called after this king, Bharatvarsh.
所以这个地球呢，就是以巴拉的马哈拉杰的名字来命名的.
Today, sometimes they will use the name Bharat for as India.
今天呢，就是把印度这片地方呢被称为 Bharat.
If you see a postage stamp. You know, if they mail a letter, they put postage stamps. So on the postage stamp, they will often write Bharat, which means India.
那么大家会见过那个邮票，邮票上面呢，他们就写着Bharat这个名字，这个就是指的印度。So
Bharat, very auspicious place, Bharatvarsha.
所以 Bharatvarsha 是一个非常吉祥的地方。And
in Bharatvarsha, the best place is called Goradesh.
而在巴拉的巴小当中，最好的一个地方呢，叫做Goradesh.
The place where Lord Chaitanya performed all of his different pastimes.
这个就是主Chaitanya上演这些不同的重要时光的地方.
And in Goradesh, the best place is called Navadvip.
而Goradesh其中最好的地方呢，叫做Navadvip.
Nava means nine, and Dvip means island.
Nava的意思是九个，Dvip的意思是岛屿.
Right now we are sitting in one of the islands, one of the nine islands.
我们现在所在的地方呢，就是这九个岛屿之一的一个岛.
We are in the island called Rudra Dvip.
我们所在的这个岛呢，叫做Rudra Dvip。Rudra,
the name of Lord Shiva.
Rudra 是主 Shiva 的一个名字。
Shiva is Lord Shiva is very important in the holy temple.
这个主 Shiva 呢，在圣地扮演着非常重要的角色。
He does many important services.
因为呢，他在这里做了很多重要的服务。
Before we can enter into the holy dam, we have to get permission from Lord Shiva.
在我们进入圣地之前呢，我们必须要得到主希瓦的允许。
We have to go to the yoga pit.
首先我们要去Yoga Pit.
The place where Lord Chaitanya.
Yoga Pit 就是主Chaitanya显现的地方。
And Lord Shiva is there.
主希瓦也在那里。
And you have to beg him for permission to enter the holy town.
所以大家要首先向他去祈祷，让他允许我们能够进入圣地。
So we said, Navadvip is the most auspicious place.
正如我们刚才所说到的，那么最吧是最为吉祥的地方。
The nine islands.
总共有九个岛屿。
In the very center, these eight islands are in the form of petals of the lotus flower.
这个有八个岛屿呢，就像这个莲花瓣一样，这个绕在周围。
And in the center is one island. In the center of the eight petals, there's one more island.
那么在这八个在周围的这八个岛屿的中间呢，还有一个岛屿。
That is called Antadvip.
这个中间的岛屿叫做安塔瑞。
Means a place of complete surrender.
这个地方指的是完全的皈依。
So in Antadvip is the yoga peak. The yoga peak. The yoga means union and peak. The place is a place where.The Lord came from the spiritual world where he descended into this world.
这个安塔瑞帕中间的这个地方呢叫做 Yoga Peak. Yoga Peak 就是连接的意思。Yoga 的意思是连接， Peak 的意思是所在地。那么 Yoga Peak 指的就是至尊主 Krishna 从灵性世界降临到这个物质世界的地方。
So it's a very, very special place.
所以它是一个非常非常吉祥特别的地方。
Sometimes devotees said to Prabhupada, they would say that, "Oh, our temple is not in the Antadvip. We are only in the Rudradvip. Maybe we should try to get the place in another place."
那有的时候呢，奉献者会对圣号帕德说道，因为我们的庙宇呢没有建设在安塔瑞帕，而是建设在了卢卡瑞帕。所以奉献者就说，是不是应该另外找个地方呢？
Because Antadvip, that is the place where the Janma Stan is, the place of the birth of Lord Chaitanya.
因为呢，这个安塔瑞帕就是主柴坦雅这个出生的地方。
But Prabhupada said no, said not important.
但是帕帕德回答说呢，不，这并不重要。
He said our temple is not the Janma Stan.But it is the karma stan.
他说呢，我们的庙宇虽然不是伽马，但是呢是karma stan.
Janma means the place of the birth.
伽马的意思是出生地。
But it said the karma stan, the place of the work, is more important.
但是他说呢，karma就是活动的地方最为重要，更为重要。
We are doing the work of Lord Chaitanya's mission.
因为呢，我们在为主柴坦雅的使命，付出活动和努力。
Lord Chaitanya came to propagate the Yuga Dharma.
主柴坦雅前来呢，是为了传播连带的宗教。
In every age, there's a different process for self-realization.
在每一个不同的年代呢，都分别有各自的觉悟自我的这个程序。
Right? Who knows what is the process in the Satya Yuga?
谁知道这个在黄金年代觉悟自我的程序是什么？
谁知道？提手。
Meditation.
Yes. Very good. Right? So, what is the process in the Treta Yuga?
Treta 年代的这个觉悟自我的方法又是什么呢？
另外一个人回答。Yes. Jisha, yes, very good. And the previous age was called Dwapara Yuga. Process was Shichidao.
那么前一个年代 Dwapara 年代这个觉悟自我的方法是什么？
崇拜。Very good. Yes, very good. So now we are in the Kali Yuga.
现在我们在卡利年代。
Only one way, right?
只有一种方式。
No other way. In the other ages, in the Kali, in the Satya Yuga, and in the Treta Yuga, and the Dwapara Yuga, they could also chant the holy name.
在其他的年代，萨迦年代、吹塔年代、瓦帕年代，人们也可以唱诵圣名。
But in the Kali Yuga, you can only chant the holy name.
但是呢，在卡里年代，这个觉悟自我的方法，唯一的方法只有唱诵圣名。
No other way.
再没有任何其他的方法。
So Lord Chaitanya came to establish the Yuga Dharma.
所以主查坦亚马哈跑步前来建立年代宗教。
He came to teach everyone how to associate with Lord Krishna through His holy name.
他前来教导我们每一个人如何通过 Krishna 的圣名来和 Krishna 联谊。
So, Lord Chaitanya is a very special, is a special, very special form of the Lord.
主财坦雅是神的一个非常
We know from the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes why he comes.
在佛家梵歌当中 ，Krishna 描述了他为何前来。
Right? Which chapter of the Bhagavad Gita tells us?
佛家梵歌当中的哪一个章节告诉我们？
Fourth chapter. What's the verse?
那个诗节是怎么说的？
Okay. Very good. Yes. Krishna describes in the fourth chapter why he comes to this world to deliver the pious, means the devotees.
Krishna 在佛家梵歌的第四章描述了他为何来到这个世界。他到来是为了拯救虔诚之人，也就是奉献者。
Most important, he had to come to please the devotees who were very anxious to see him.
这个最重要的是，他前来是。
Only Krishna could kill them.
当然了，有一些恶魔，比如说堪萨和西施炮，只有 Krishna 才能够杀死他们。
So he came, and by killing them, he liberated them.
但是呢，通过杀死这些恶魔，Krishna 使他们获得了解脱。
So he's when he comes, he's kind to everyone. Krishna gives his mercy to everyone when he comes in this world.
当 Krishna 来到这个世界的时候呢，他将他的仁慈赐予每一个人。
He kills the demons so that they get liberation.
他杀死恶魔也是为了让他们得到解脱。
And he gives pleasure to his devotees.
并且呢，他也给他的奉献者们带来快乐。
And he has to also reestablish the religious principles.
与此同时呢，他也同时建立了宗教原则。
So Krishna came 5,000 years ago and did all of this.
那么 Krishna 从Krishna 5,000年前来到这个世界，做了所有这些事情。
And then 500 years ago, Krishna came again.
500年前呢 ，Krishna 再次来到这里。
But he comes in a different form.
但是呢，他是以不同的形象前来的。
Well.Say a different color.
你们可以说他们就是他有着不同的肤色。
In every age, the Lord comes in different colors.
在每一个年代，主 Krishna 呢以不同的肤色显现。
Just like in the Satya Yuga, the Lord comes in a white color.
比如说在黄金年代、萨提亚年代的时候，主 Krishna 以白色的肤色显现。
And he carries.He wears the deer skin because he is going to do meditation.
因为呢，他要去从事冥想，所以他只穿着那个皮 皮毛。
鹿皮。
鹿皮啊，他穿着鹿皮是为了去冥想。
And then in the Treta Yuga, he's a red color.
那么在灵性年代呢，他是红色的肤色。
And he brings the things to do the fire sacrifice.
而且他带来了这个一些物品是用来做祭祀用的。
Yeah, they have special wooden spoons which they use.
他们做祭祀的时候会用一种很特别的木头。
So the Lord comes in his dress like that, ready to do the fire sacrifice.
所以，主呢以这样的方式打扮自己，以便方便去从事祭祀活动。
Then in Dwapara Yuga, he comes in the blackish color.
那么在多阿帕年代，同性年代呢？他以黑色的肤色显现。
Now, when Lord Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago, Nanda Maharaj had Lord Krishna in his home, and he brought Garga Muni to be the priest to do a ceremony for his child.
那么在5000年前 Krishna 显现的时候呢 ，Nanda Maharaj 让这个就是 Krishna 显现在了 Nanda Maharaj 家里。然后 Nanda Maharaj 呢，他就邀请来了 Garga Muni 来为这个新生儿做一个仪式。
Yeah, they have to do a name giving ceremony for the child.
因为孩子出生之后呢，家长们要举行这个取名的仪式。
So Vasudev had told Nanda Maharaj.
Vasudev 就告诉 Nanda Maharaj.
You get Garga Muni here. Garga Muni will be the good priest.
就告诉他呢，要邀请 Garga Muni 过来，因为 Garga Muni 是非常。就是有资格的祭祀。
So when the child is born, then the Brahmin comes and he will calculate everything about the child.
这个孩子出生之后呢，这个很多的婆罗门就会过来，然后计算他的这个出生的星象图。
They will calculate they will ask first of all, what was the exact time of the birth of the child?
这些婆罗门首先会问这个孩子出生的精确的时间。
And then they will calculate the position of each of the planets at that time.
然后呢，他们就根据这个时间去计算这个不同星体的所在位置。
And then they will make predictions about the character of this child.
然后他们就根据这些星象的位置来去预测这个新生孩子的品质。
So Garga Muni, he calculated everything for Nanda Maharaj's child, and then he told him, "Oh, this child has taken birth in different times, in different colors."
这个所以说 ，Garga Muni 呢，就给 Nanda Maharaj 这个新生儿子呢做了这个星象的计算。然后对 Nanda Maharaj 说，你的这个孩子在不同的年代以不同的肤色曾经显现过。
And he told him he has had a red color and a white color, a yellow color. Now he has a blackish.
然后他跟他说呢，他之前以白色、红色、白色、红色的肤色显现，那么现在呢，他将以黑色的肤色显现。
还有黄。
色，之前以白色、白色、红色、黄色的肤色显现过，现在呢以黑色显现。
In the Kali Yuga, it comes in the yellow color, golden color.
在卡利年代，它是以黄色的肤色，就是金黄色的肤色显现的。
So Garga Muni was describing about the previous Kali Yuga.
所以 Garga Muni 实际上它讲述的是之前的卡利年代。
In every day of Brahma, there's the cycle of the four ages.
在 Brahma 的一天当中呢，有四个年代的循环。
Sahasra Yuga Paryantam Haryat Brahmanovidu. And there are 1,000 cycles of the ages in one day of Brahma.
在 Brahma 的一天当中呢，有1000个4个年代的循环。
So that means in one day of Brahma, you have 1,000 Kali Yugas.
这意味着在 Brahma 的一天当中呢，有1000个 Kali 年代。
There's also 1,000 Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga.
也有1000个 Satya 年代, 1000个 Treta 年代, 1000个 Dwapara 年代.
But the child who appeared 5,000 years ago is not just simply an avatar for the Yuga.
但是呢，这个5000年前显现的这个孩子呢？ 不仅仅是这个年代的化身,
but he's a very special avatar who comes only once in the one day of Brahma.
而且呢，他是一个非常特别的化身, 因为呢，这个化身在 Brahma 的一天只是前来一次.
Now, usually in the other ages, when the Lord comes, he will be an avatar of Vishnu. He will be coming from Vishnu.
那么通常而言呢，在其他的年代，Krishna都是以Vishnu的这个化身降临的。
But the Krishna who came 5,000 years ago, he was not the Vishnu avatar. He was the Supreme Personality of God.
但是当Krishna5000年前前来的时候呢，他并不是属于Vishnu化身，而是至尊人格守神本人。
You get avatars who come every age to do the work of the Yuga Dharma.
这个每一个年代呢，都会有一个化身前来建立这个年代的宗教。
But you get on very rare occasions, you get the Supreme Lord Himself coming.
但是呢，至尊人格守神本人前来是非常非常罕有的。
Just like 5,000 years ago, Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, came.
就像5000年前至尊人格守神本人主 Krishna 亲自前来。
So he was not avatar, but he is avatari, means he is the source of all the avatars.
所以呢，他不是avatar，就是不能把它称为化身，他是avatari，也就是说他是所有化身的源头。
He did not come just simply to do the work of the Yuga Dharma.
他前来呢，并不仅仅是为了建立年代的宗教。He
came to give very great pleasure to his devotees.
他前来是为了给他伟大的奉献者们带来快乐。And
similarly, when Lord Chaitanya appeared 500 years ago, he is not just simply the Yuga avatar, but he is the Supreme Lord himself.
同样的呢，当圣主查泰亚马哈帕布，500年前降临的时候，他不仅仅是年代的化身，而是主本人。So
Lord Chaitanya comes only once in the day of Brahma.
所以说，主查泰亚呢，只在 Brahma 的一天当中只降临一次。You
know how many millions of years that is?
你们知道这意味着是多少百万年吗？
One Kali Yuga is how many years?
一个卡尼年代有多少年？43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。43万。
one cycle of the four ages is 10 times the duration of Kali Yuga. So it's 431.
这个四个年代循环的这个长度，八年年代那个时长的。And there are 1,000 cycles. So
you have to multiply that by 1,000.
所以说，在这个基础之上再乘以1,000.
So 431 multiplied by 1,000. That's one day of Brahma, 12 hours of Brahma's time. 431 multiplied by 1,000.
431万年乘以1,000.
Is one day of Brahma.
就是 Brahma 的一天.
So the Lord only comes once. In that time.
所以这个在这么长的时间当中，主只降临一次。
He comes once as Krishna, and he comes once as Lord Chaitanya.
他作为主 Krishna 本人呢，只来一次。
So,
主 Chaitanya 也是只来一次。
So Lord Chaitanya appeared here in this place.
主 Chaitanya 呢就显现在这个地方。
Mayapur Dham.
Mayapur 圣地。
It's a holy place.
是一个神圣的地方。
Why is it a holy place?
为什么是个神圣的地方呢？
Well, for one reason, Ganges is here.
其中的一个原因就是恒河流经这里。
Wherever the Ganges flows, that is a holy place.
无论恒河流经什么地方呢，这个地方就成为圣地。
Who has been to Eka Chakra? 谁去过 Eka Chakra?
谁去过阿格查法？
没有多少。
早几天。
我们准备过几天去。
So if you go to Eka Chakra, it's a place where Lord Nityananda appeared.
Eka Chakra is the Lord Nityananda's residence.
So it is called Radha Desh. Radha Desh means the place where the Ganges does not flow.
This Eka Chakra 那块地方呢被称为 Radha Desh. Radha Desh 的意思是就是恒河没有流经的地方。
But it is also a holy place.
但它仍然是一个圣地。
Because if the Pandavas go there, then it's a holy
place. 因为呢，如果潘达瓦五兄弟去了那里，那里就是圣地。
The five Pandavas they had gone to Eka Chakra.
因为潘达瓦五兄弟曾经去过 Eka Chakra.
Lord Nityananda appeared there in that place.
而且呢，主尼提亚南达也在那个地方显现。
Were you born in a holy place?你们出生在一个圣地吗？
你们出生在圣地吗？
没有。
But if you become a pure devotee, then that place becomes a holy place.
但是呢，如果你们成为了一名纯粹的奉献者，那个地方就成了圣地。
Wherever the devotees are, that is a holy place.
无论什么地方有奉献者在。那个地方呢，就成为圣地。
If there's a holy place and no pure devotees, it's not very good.
如果仅仅是圣地，而圣地却没有纯粹的奉献者的话，这就不那么重要了。
But if we have a place which is not pious, which is not holy, but if there are pure devotees there, then it's a very special place, very holy.
但是呢，如果一个地方即使它不是圣地，但是如果那里有纯粹的奉献者在，那么呢，那个地方就会成为非常特别的，好的地方。
Krishna consciousness movement is for making holy places all over the world.
Krishna 知觉运动呢，是为了在全世界每个地方建立圣地。
Wherever the devotees are chanting the holy name and worshipping Krishna, and teaching the glories of Krishna, then becomes a holy place.
无论什么地方呢，有奉献者们在唱诵圣名，在崇拜 Krishna， 在赞美 Krishna 的荣耀，那么呢，这个地方就会成为圣地。
This place is a holy place because devotees came here because the Lord also Lord Chaitanya appeared here.
这个地方之所以成为圣地，是因为奉献者们都来到这里，而且呢，这里也是主 Chaitanya 的显现地。
So we can also make holy places everywhere.
所以呢，我们可以在任何地方，所有的地方都可以建立圣地。
We carry Krishna in our heart.
我们把 Krishna 放在我们的心中。
So wherever we go, becomes a holy place.
所以说，无论我们去到哪里，那里呢都会成为圣地。
Just like.If you have a disease, there, you know this typhoid? No? There are some diseases which are contagious. You give it to other people.
Oh, okay. 就比如说某个人得了传染病。
Yeah. So there was one lady, she had this disease. Everywhere she went, wherever she met people, they all got the same disease.
就有一位女士呢，就得了某种传染病，然后不管她走到哪里呢，她就把她的那个病就传给了周围的人。
And so the same way, devotees, wherever devotees go, They give Krishna consciousness. They make other people devotees.
所以相似的呢，奉献者也是这样。无论奉献者走到哪里，他就把 Krishna 知觉给予别人。
Wherever we go, we're giving prasadam. People are seeing the neck beads. They see them. They hear the holy name.
所以说，同样的呢，奉献者无论走到哪里，他们就开发菩萨的，然后那些人呢，就也能够看见奉献者们在唱诵圣名，带着锦珠。
So they have, they make many, many holy places.
所以以这样的方式呢，我们可以建立起很多很多的圣地。
Prabhupada went to Hong Kong.
泡泡德曾经去过香港。
Hong Kong became a holy place.
所以说香港变成了一个圣地。
Was blessed with the dust of the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada.
因为呢，香港得到了圣泡泡德的莲花足下的尘土的祝福。
So Krishna consciousness was inaugurated in the Kali Yuga here in this place with the birth of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna consciousness began here.
这个就是Krishna 知觉呢，就是在这里发源的，就是在这个 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的出生地所发源的。
But before Lord Chaitanya appeared.Other devotees came.
但是在主查坦尼亚马哈帕布显现之前呢，有很多的奉献者先显现。
Just like before Krishna's birth, many things happened.
就好比在圣主 Krishna 显现之前呢，也发生了很多事情。
All right, we know Vasudeva and Devaki had to come, and Nanda and Yashoda had to come.
因为在此之前呢 ，Vasudeva 和 Devaki 要先降临。然后 Nanda 和 Yashoda 也要先显现。
And so many other friends of Krishna, his cowherd boyfriends.
还有他的很多的牧牛朋友。
And before Krishna came, Balaram came.
在 Krishna 降临之前呢 ，Balarama 先显现的。
Balaram came first in the womb of Devaki, and then transferred to the womb of Rohini.
巴拉拉玛他首先在 Devaki 的子宫中显现，然后被转移到了 Rohini 的子宫。
So the same way before Lord Chaitanya appeared, Lord Nityananda appeared.
所以同样的呢，在主 Chaitanya 显现之前呢，主 Nityananda 先显现了。
Lord Chaitanya is Krishna, and Lord Nityananda is Balarama.
主 Chaitanya 就是 Krishna, 主 Nityananda 就是 Balarama.
So, Balarama appeared before Krishna. The same with Nityananda, he's older than Lord Chaitanya.
Balarama 比这个 Krishna 要早一点出生。同样的呢 ,Nityananda 要比Chaitanya 要年长。
And Lord Chaitanya also,had an older brother before he was, before Lord Chaitanya took birth, his mother and father had also a son, and so Lord Chaitanya had an older brother, material brother.
那么呢，因为呢，这个 Nityananda, 不是，同样的呢，这个 Chaitanya 呢，他有一个哥哥。那么在主 Chaitanya 显现之前呢，他的父母还有一个儿子，所以说呢，他有一个哥哥。
His name was Vishwarup.
他的名字，他哥哥的名字叫 Vishwarup.
He was like an expansion of Nityananda.
他就好比是主 Nityananda 的一个扩展。
So, but after some time, the older brother of Lord Chaitanya, he left home.
但是呢，这个主 Chaitanya 他的哥哥 Vishwarup, 他离开了家。
And he went, he never came back again to the home.
他离开家之后呢，就再也没有回来。
He became a sannyasi.
成了一个 sannyasi.
And he wandered in the holy places.
在各个不同的圣地去朝圣。
And he left his, departed from this world in a holy place.
而且呢，他也是在圣地离开这个世界的。
Not this place, not this holy place, but another holy place.
不是这个地方，是另外的一个圣地。
There are many, many holy places.
有很多很多的圣地。
Because wherever the devotees go, they make holy places.
因为呢，无论奉献者们去到哪里，他们就会把那个地方变成圣地。
It's like when you go and travel around India, people will tell you, oh, this is a holy place.
就如果你们在这个印度各个不同的地方去旅行的话，人们就会告诉你们这里那里有很多不同的圣地。
They'll tell you some pastime. There's some pond, a little lake somewhere. They'll say, oh, a very special pastime took place there.
然后他们也会为你讲述这些圣地所发生的不同的逍遥时光。他们会告诉你，比如说有一个池塘，这里是一个非常特别的地方，上演过逍遥时光。
Or if there's a hill or a mountain somewhere, they'll tell you about the yogis who did their austerities there.
或者是说，如果有一个这个山峰的话，他们就会告诉你某一个某一位瑜伽师曾经在这个山上从事过苦行。
So going to holy places is not the most important purpose.That we come here for.
所以说去圣地呢并不是我们最为重要的一个目的。
More important is to hear from the holy men, holy people who live there.
更为重要的呢是要去聆听那些居住在圣地的那些圣人去从他们那里聆听。
We don't just come for to look.We don't get a lot of purification through the eyes. You get more purification through the ear.
我们来到这里呢，并不是为了仅仅是为了观光而已。我们通过眼睛去看，并不能得到很多的净化。但是呢，如果我们去聆听，我们就可以得到更多的净化。
Lord Chaitanya gave great importance to the hearing process.
主差坦雅他非常的强调这个聆听的程序。
We have to hear regularly.
我们必须经常的有规律的去聆听。
And Lord Chaitanya also liked to hear regularly. He would hear Srimad Bhagavatam from the devotees.
而且主差坦雅本人呢也是非常去喜欢聆听的，他会从奉献者们那里去聆听圣典薄伽瓦坛。
Lord Chaitanya lived here in Mayapur for 24 years.
主差坦雅在 Mayapur 这个地方居住了24年。
And then, 24 years, after 24 years, one day, he woke up early in the morning and he swam across the Ganga.
24年之后的某一天呢，他就在清晨醒来，然后越过恒河。
Right? Are you good swimmers?
你们是游泳行家吗？
嗯，可以。Can you swim across the Ganga?
你们能够游过恒河吗？
可以。
Current is very strong. The current can carry you.
这个恒河的这个水流是非常急的，它可能会把你带走。
Even elephants sometimes fall on the Ganga. They cannot get out.
甚至是有的时候，大象掉进了恒河里面都没办法再出来。
You have to be very careful.
所以要非常的小心。
Many people leave their body in the Ganga.
很多人都是在恒河离开了躯体。
We don't want any of us to leave the body in the Ganga.
我不希望我们中的任何一个人在恒河当中离开躯体。
Right? Not yet. You're not pure enough yet.
你们还不够纯粹。
You need the purity.
你们需要正法。
So the Ganges, what we're speaking about now, Ganges flowing here.
Gave importance to the hearing process.
Oh, the hearing process, right. Yeah. Okay, so hearing, this is the main program. Coming on Parikrama, we go to see the holy places and we hear about the pastimes which took place there.
我们有一个很重要的活动，就是 Parikrama， 也就是去绕拜整个岛屿。那么在绕拜的过程当中呢，我们会去到不同的地方，并且讲述那些地方所上演过的逍遥时光。
Now here in this holy place, Mayapur, we don't have any other business except hearing and chanting and remembering Krishna.
那么来到 Mayapur 这个地方呢，我们除了聆听、唱诵和忆念主 Krishna 的逍遥时光之外呢，再没有别的事情。
Lord Chaitanya especially liked to hear about Dhruva Maharaj and Prahlad Maharaj.
主 Chaitanya 尤其喜欢聆听 Dhruva Maharaj 和 Prahlad Maharaj 的故事。
And he would hear these pastimes, he would hear the Srimad Bhagavatam.Describing the pastimes of Dhruva and Prahlad Maharaj, he would hear them again and again.
他会去聆听圣典薄伽瓦堂当中有关多尔玛哈拉姐和普拉达玛哈拉姐的故事。他会一遍又一遍地去聆听这些逍遥时光。
He would also tell his mother about these pastimes.
他会把这些逍遥时光讲给他的妈妈听。
Because when he was planning to go away from home.His mother found out. She was not happy. She was upset. She didn't want her son to leave home.
因为呢，当主查坦雅想要就是有计划要离开家的时候呢，他的母亲就发现了这个他的这个计划，因此呢，感到非常的难过。他不希望他的儿子离开家。
So Lord Chaitanya told his mother about the pastimes of Dhruva Maharaj.
所以说主查坦雅呢就为他的母亲讲了 Dhruva Maharaja 的故事。
And he was telling how his mother, the mother of Dhruva Maharaj, she told Dhruva Maharaj that if you want to find Krishna, you should go into the forest. You'll find him there.
他就讲到呢，这个 Dhruva Maharaja 的母亲就对 Dhruva Maharaja 说道，如果你想找到 Krishna, 如果你想找到至尊神的话，你就要去森林。
Yeah, many people, she told him, many great sages, yogis, they go to the forest, they find Krishna there.
有很多的这个故事就讲到许多伟大的圣人，许多伟大的瑞士们就去到森林里找到了 Krishna.
So Dhruva Maharaj took that advice and he went. Although he was only 5 years old, a young boy, he was not afraid. He went into the jungle.
所以多阿玛哈拉者呢，他就接受了他母亲的这个建议，就去到了森林。虽然呢他只有五岁，但是呢他并不害怕。
And he stayed there for 6 months, and after within 6 months, the Supreme Lord came to see him to give blessings.
那么多阿玛哈拉者就在森林里待了六个月的时间，在短短的六个月时间之内呢，这个至尊主 Krishna 就显现在了多阿玛哈拉者的面前。
So,was a great success for Dhruva Maharaj.
这对于 Dhruva Maharaj 来说是一个极大的成功。
His father was very proud of him. His father made him the king.
他的父亲呢，对他感到非常的自豪。他的父亲并让他成为了国王。
And Dhruva ruled the world. He ruled the kingdom for many years.
Dhruva Maharaj 呢，他统治了这个整个世界很多很多年。
And then Dhruva Maharaj decided he wanted to retire, and he went to the Himalayas.
之后呢 ，Dhruva Maharaj 决定要退休，他就去了喜马拉雅山。
And he stayed in the Himalayas doing austerity.
他就去了喜马拉雅山从事苦修。
And one day, airplane came from Vaikuntha.
有一天呢，来自外昆塔的这个飞机。到了
and they said, this is to take you back to the spiritual world.
这个飞机上的人就说呢，这个是来接你去外昆塔星球的。
So Dhruva got in the airplane, but then he remembered, he said, wait a minute, what about my mother?
这个 Dhruva Maharaj 呢就登上了这个飞机，但是呢他登上飞机之后就在想，那我的妈妈该怎么办呢？
She was my guru.
他说我的妈妈是我的guru。
She told me where to find Krishna.
是他告诉我在哪里去寻找 Krishna 的。
But the man in the airplane, he said, "Oh look, don't worry. There's another airplane there. She's also going back to the spiritual world."
但是呢，这个飞机上的人就对杜瓦玛哈拉者说道："不要担心，这还有另外一架飞机，来接你的妈妈，带她去到灵性世界。
"So Dhruva Maharaj was very happy.
所以杜阿玛拉吉就非常的高兴。
They both went back to Godhead.
他们两个人呢，杜阿玛拉吉和他的妈妈一起去到了外昆塔。
Lord Chaitanya told this story to his mother. His mother was very happy.
所以说，主查坦雅呢就把这个故事讲给他的母亲听。他的母亲呢听了这个故事就变得非常的高兴。
Because she thought, well, my son is going to take sannyas. It's like going into the forest, like Dhruva Maharaj.
他这样想呢，因为我的儿子马上就要去当萨尼亚西了，这就跟杜瓦马哈拉贾去到森林是一样的。
So a great benefit. I will also get to go back to Godhead.
这是一个非常有益处的，说不定我也会和他一起去到灵性世界。
So the mother was relieved of her anxiety, her worries about her son becoming a sannyasi.
所以说他的母亲呢就得到了这个缓解，就不再那么焦虑，因为他的儿子要马上要成为萨尼亚西。
So this Dhruva Maharaj was preaching, convincing his mother how to also accept Krishna consciousness.
所以杜瓦马哈拉贾就以这样的方式去说服他的母亲，去向他的母亲传教，让他也具有 Krishna 知觉。
So if we also understand these pastimes, we can also tell them to our relatives and family members and friends and convince them about Krishna consciousness.
如果我们理解了这些故事的话，我们也可以把这些故事讲给我们的亲戚朋友，去听，让他们也具有 Krishna 知觉。
Lord Chaitanya telling wherever he told us, wherever you go, wherever you meet.Tell them about Krishna.
主查坦雅告诉我们，无论你走到哪里，无论你遇见什么人，你都要向他们讲述 Krishna.
You all know about Dhruva Maharaj. You all know about Prahlad Maharaj. You should tell people about these great personalities.
你们都知道杜瓦马哈拉贾的故事，你们都知道普拉达马哈拉贾的故事，你们应该把他们的这些故事呢，去讲给别人听。
We have to practice speaking about Krishna.
我们应该做这个练习，去讲述 Krishna.
We have to practice remembering Krishna.
我们要去练习，去冥想 Krishna, 铭记 Krishna.
Just like in Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna said, "Oh, it's very difficult. I can't control my mind."
正如在《博伽梵歌》当中说。Arjuna 说，心意是非常难以控制的。
But Krishna said, "You can do it. I know it's difficult, but you can do it by practice."
但是 Krishna 回答说呢，我知道这是很难的，但是呢，通过练习还是可以做到的。
So we have come to this holy place to practice remembering Krishna.
所以说，我们来到圣地呢，要去练习冥想和记忆 Krishna。
Now, of course, you come here, maybe, obviously, you're not as comfortable as you would be at home. You have your nice, comfortable home, but you come here, live in this place. It's maybe noisy, and mosquitoes, and so many disturbances.
当然了，你们来到这个地方呢，可能比起你们在家的时候就没有那么舒适了，因为你们都有非常舒适的家，但是来到这里呢，可能就有一点这个嘈杂呀，有蚊子呀，就可能没有那么舒适。
Many dogs at night and the jackals also barking all night.
还有这个很多的狗啊，在晚上的时候还有这个豺狼啊在叫。
Right. Do you hear them?
你们晚上听到那个声音了吗？
听到了。
在那个丛林里，在那边。
So, yeah, there are many inconveniences coming here.
所以在这里的话，可能会有很多的不方便。
But there's also a lot of benefit spiritually.
但是虽然如此呢？在这里还是有很多灵性的收益的，灵性的好处。
We are accepting the difficulties for Krishna.
我们为了 Krishna 接受所有的这些不便。
Krishna appreciates that.
Krishna 会欣赏你们的这一点的。
So take advantage try to do more service for Krishna.
所以要充分地利用这个条件，试着去为 Krishna 做更多的服务。
More chanting.
更多的唱诵。
More healing.
更多的聆听。
Less prasada.
少吃一点 prasada.
Don't eat too much.
不要吃太多的。
Right? Don't eat too much. Don't eat too little.
不要吃太多，也不要吃的太少。
我不会吃太少。我可以吃多。Okay, any questions?
现在大家有没有什么问题？